In the past 24 hours, the head of state, Tuimalea Liifanu Va'aleatoa Sualauvi II, made an appearance. He hasn't actually been seen for the past 6 weeks, but he made an appearance on television last night at 11:30 p.m. Samoa time to essentially say that he doesn't think that the parliament should convene until August 2nd. It was a direct contradiction to what the Supreme Court ruled last week, saying that they had a week to convene, or anyone who didn't let that process happen would be seen as being in contempt of court. Now, the head of state gave various reasons as to why he thinks that the parliament should not be convened. And as the head of state under Samoa's constitution, it is up to him to convene parliament. So he was pretty much saying that no party has the majority of numbers. He's also saying that the women's seat debacle hasn't been settled yet. He also said that because of the electoral petitions, the ongoing electoral petitions and by-elections, there are already 4 by-elections slated already, that there is no certainty, and therefore he is saying August 2nd is the time to convene parliament. Now, what's particularly interesting about those things that he said is that, one, the FAST party, they won the election and continue to have the seats. They have 26 compared to the HRPP's 21. And also in that, in when he was saying that, you know, they can't sit because these ongoing electoral petitions are in front of the court, that hasn't stopped a Samoan parliament in the past doing it. So there's a lot of confusion as to what he said and if he actually had the grounds to say it. He also took a swipe at the Supreme Court, saying that they flagrantly disregarded and disrespected his power as the head of state as well, saying that they don't respect him. But, you know, since those comments have been made, people have come out to say that, you know, the head of state, yes, it is his job to convene parliament within the constitution, but it's not unfettered power and he has to do so in a timely manner, which he hasn't done.
Speaking of power, now we've got the head of state in direct confrontation with the Supreme Court. Mm-hmm. How do you see this thing playing out? What's going to happen next? Can you predict it?
That is the big question. And I feel like if I knew the answer, I could, you know, go to the bank with it. So all eyes are definitely on the Supreme Court as to how they will respond to the fact that he says that, you know, I'm not going to convene parliament. He's already gone past the 7 days. It was supposed to be today when parliament sat. So he's already looking like he is in contempt of court. So as well as looking at the courts, people will be looking at the Samoan police because of those contempt orders. Now, in terms of the courts, they had already said that, you know, failure for court to sit would then mean that they would have to revisit the doctrine of necessity, which is the doctrine that the Fa'atuatua Ele Atua Samoa or Tasi Party or FAST Party used when they had that swearing in on May 24. That swearing was set to be void, but the court did say that, you know, if Parliament fails to convene, that swearing may be seen as a legal swearing in. People, as I said, also looking to the police. Samoa has an unarmed police force as to what they are going to do. The police have said that they will stay impartial and unbiased. They act very peacefully, generally in accordance to what the courts have said to them. Today, the Samoa Observer, the local newspaper, are reporting that the HRPP have actually filed a criminal police complaint against the leaders of the FAST party and their legal team for that swearing in. So this is not a problem that's going to go away very easily. And we also have to mention as well is that, of course, a lot of people are saying, well, maybe it's time that international figures step in and, you know, do something about this. One commentator saying that, you know, they do need to step in and drag them out of office if they need to, because this is where it is getting to. We did reach out to DFAT for their response. They are sticking by the comments of the Foreign Minister, Maurice Payne, which he made a while ago, pretty much saying that Australia, you know, respects their right as a country to do what they need to do, but wishes that both parties can, you know, cooperate and come to a conclusion.
So many legal, political and now, as you mentioned, social twists and turns. Now, the people that are really in the middle of this are Samoan citizens themselves. How are they taking all this?
Tired, exhausted. They want it to be over. You have to remember that Samoa was seen as a normal, stable democracy across the Pacific. Like, Samoa is not your Fiji. They don't have military coups. And that is something that I think Samoans really prided themselves in. And I also think that they just thought they went to the polls and an answer was given and then they didn't have to think about it anymore. This Friday, it'll be 3 months since they went to the polls and there's still no clear idea about who is in charge in Samoa. We've got the leader of the FAST party, Fiamme Naomi Mataafa, saying that she is the Prime Minister, but we've also got Tuilaepa and his HRPP as the caretaker government right now. So I think people in Samoa just want this to be over. They're sick of waking up every Monday to have a new twist and turn. And also they're concerned about how it makes Samoa look on the international stage as well. And they are concerned that this whole farce is making, you know, Samoa and the people in Samoa look like fools.
Yeah, Talia, obviously between now and August, if Parliament convenes, then there's clearly a lot of developments. And I know you'll keep us up to date. Cheers, Talia.
Indeed. Thank you.